Hi guys, Dave with Air School here, and I think the biggest friction that our clients have had and probably many split users in general are having is the installation process. And so we've come up with the Air School quick and easy system that allows you to do the connectivity portion of setting up a mini split in plus or minus 5 minutes. So what we do is this unit right here, if you were to get this unit, it will have been had everything pre-installed, and we'll actually run it for a few minutes to make sure everything's good. So the refrigerant lines here, for instance, they're pre-installed. They contain refrigerant already. The indoor unit on the other side of this wall contains refrigerant. So all you need to do is at this one point, screw these two connectors together. Normally what you need to do, this is probably the toughest step, you need to get maybe your brother-in-law who can be a little flaky or your friend's neighbor who's can be a bit of a tweaker. These types of people, it's hard, good people are hard to find. So you want to take it on yourself, do it yourself project. But if you do that and you don't have the refrigerant gauges, the vacuum pump, the nitrogen tank, probably most systems require a torque wrench. You're going to either have to borrow that or you're going to have to buy it. And do you really have need for these tools later on? Do you want to really want to put time into learning how to use them? And even if you do, there's no guaranteed success. You may have an issue with cross-threading on the flared fittings, common problem. Leaks are a common problem. So this is guaranteed success in plus or minus 5 minutes, okay? On the electrical side of things, most mini splits don't even come with an alternating cord. We have the right gauge for right amperage wire pre-installed onto this unit. The communication control wire that also supplies power to the inside unit has been pre-installed to the connectivity block on both the outside unit and the inside unit. So all that pretty time consuming, but we've taken care of that for you. You don't need to put your bifocals on and make sure the wires are in the right order, because if the wires are not coded correctly, the right color code here and there, the unit might fly aboard. Who knows? Their problems would be imminent. It wouldn't run. You'd get frustrated. So we've taken care of all that for you. And then finally, for our mini split, it's a solar powered hybrid mini split. So we have these whips that have MC4 connectors. So we provide you with these pre-installed, and we also provide you with this DC isolator box. Okay. So, Todd, where are we at in terms of time so far for me yammering?
3 minutes.
So we're at 3 minutes. Now we're going to do the actual, we're going to subtract that off the actual install. So we'll start with doing the line set. You'll see there's refrigerant lines come in two sizes. There's always larger and smaller. In our case, larger is the 3/8. So we're going to match it with the 3/8 line here. And these can't be cross-threaded because they're steel, and they're also they're coated steel such that they're fine to be outside. And this is not very compelling video. Feel free to fast forward. But of the 5 plus or minus minutes to do this, it's probably 2 or 3 minutes is doing this part I'm doing right now. So feel free to fast forward. But notice that for what we're doing right here, we're only having to do this in one spot. There are competitive systems that need 2 wrenches at both the indoor unit and outdoor unit. This is only in one spot, okay? And yeah, you don't need any tools for this. It's handy to have gloves. We might start including those in the kit as well. But if you have manly hands, it's not necessary. So do this all the way to the end. All right, and now we'll do the quarter inch line. Thank you. So once these are connected, the refrigerant now is one in the system. It's connect, the indoor unit and outdoor unit are fully connected, fully precharged with the right amount of refrigerant. So you never have to worry about that aspect of it. All right, done. So now the refrigerant line, that's the hard part. That part's done. Now we're going on to the electrical part. So this wire right here connects the outdoor unit with the indoor unit. It supplies power to the indoor unit. And also the printed circuit board in this controls most aspects of the indoor unit. So to do this, you twist until, I like twisting counterclockwise so the pins line up, push forward, and then about 1/15th of the turn, that's done. This you can probably handle. Whoops, maybe you can't. This you can probably handle plugging your power cord into an outlet. Normally you'll probably have an outdoor outlet. We have this one's just a dummy outlet, which Todd will show, but this one's live. So everything's done here now. For the solar, just take the female MC4 connector, put it on the male. And this should be in the off position before we go. And then the male on the female, turn that on. And voila, we're done. How long did that take, Todd?
7 minutes.
7 minutes. We start out with three, so we're at less than five, right? And even with me doing a little bit more yammering. So turning the unit on. In the room right now, it's 77 degrees. And this coil it takes a minute to get cold. It's going down. So the refrigerant, I can hear, you probably can't hear it in the video, but the refrigerant's starting to come through this indoor coil here. So as the refrigerant circulates through that coil, the supply air comes through, or return air comes through here, supply air comes out here. It's totally ductless. That's how many splits work. And while we're waiting for it to cool down, yes, this filter is another advantage of a mini split is you don't need to pay 10, 12 bucks on filters every month. You just take these out and rinse them out and you're good. Okay, so our coil here now, 63, 62, 60. So it'll get down to maybe 45 degrees. And yeah, so hopefully you see that that's a little bit easier than the traditional way of installing a mini split. The installation process, still a lot of work putting this unit on the wall, et cetera. And that we can't do that for you, but I think we've taken here probably the biggest time eaters in the installation process. So if this seems useful to you, check out airspool.com. Subscribe to this YouTube channel, Airspool. Appreciate your time. Thank you.